Swadhi Kap, and welcome to my presentation. I am Gazanla. Today I will be presenting on design of control system separation scheme for identity operation of proton grid using waves. This research is being carried out under the advice of Professor Dr. Nivan Hinchari. This is the outline of my presentation. I will be today touching upon the motivation, problem statement, scope of the work, methodology adopted for this research work, and we will be also touching on the proposed solution, expected results and contribution, and conclude. Proton power system network is a very unique system whereby it has high generation capacity, and currently there are about 4000 megawatt generation, but only about 30% of its generation is being used within the country, whereby rest 70% is exported to vast Indian power system network. Therefore, whenever there is a blackout or some outage in the Indian power system network, the major system disturbance is felt in Bhutan power system network too. Therefore, design for control separation of Bhutan grid during the faulty Indian grid is felt very, very important. By using the wide area monitoring system, which will be working on phasor measurement unit and superphases, will be a very essential part for this project. Bhutan's power system network has many problems, but out of that, if I put out three major currently existing problems, is that whenever there is a grid disturbance in Indian power system network, Bhutan power system network also experiences the same effect. Sometimes even the entire nation's grid collapses whenever there is a disturbance in Indian power system network, which means that the Bhutan's current protection scheme is not able to handle high current faults during the blackout in Indian power system network. Therefore, it lacks a control separation scheme on Indian network and operate in islanding mode. Now, the scope of our research is firstly to study the WEMS architecture and application of both Bhutan as well as Indian power system network, and we should be able to collect sufficient data from any wide area monitoring systems like PMU for modeling and simulation. And we will be adopting the best method of technology for control separation scheme and design a system model for computation. We will be developing a user interface for monitoring, operation and control. The methodology adopted for this research is that primarily we will be carrying out some preliminary studies followed by literature review. After determining the objective and scope of the work, we will formulate the problem and determine the best solution method. We will be building models for both the power system and WEMS and test it. And after testing, we will be analyzing the results and conclude. The solution provided proposed for this research work is that we are going for frequency control separation scheme using WEMS. Here the phasor measurement unit or superphases will be the wide area monitoring system whereby it will provide the real-time data for the monitoring, control and operation using frequency control. And whenever there is certain changes in the frequency of the system, the PMU or wide area monitoring system should be able to sense it and provide it into the scheme, whereby it will ensure only the affected areas are disconnected and preserve the unaffected India should be able to operate in the energy mode. And we are proposing a used power control algorithm considering all the generation, load demand and system stability, and we will use mathematical models based on all system equations for accurate representation. Now, out of many results, the expected major expected results or contributions from this research is that this model is being developed for the first time in the Bhutan Power System Network, and we are expecting it to build a dynamic system model with actual data from PMU of both India and Bhutan grid, which will be an effective approach for energy operation for Bhutan grid. And this scheme will be detecting frequency changes and initiate control separation whenever there is a disturbance or major outage in the Indian system. And we are also expecting it to build a user interface for monitoring, control and operation during separation, system separation. We are also expecting to provide many information, insights into the power system behavior during the energy operation and inform the upcoming future strategies so that the Bhutan power system will be ready to face any upcoming challenges in the future. To conclude my presentation, the proposed scheme with the frequency control scheme using MEMS for LNG operation of Bhutan whenever there is a system outage or major blackout in the grid is a very effective solution, and it will ensure a reliable power supply, reduce risk of power system collapse whenever there is a system collapse in Indian grid site. And it will provide not only this reliable power supply, but it should also be able to improve stability and reliability of Bhutan grid to reinforce the Indian grid, because it will be able to separate itself from the Indian grid and operate in island mode. And it will also be a potential for enhancing overall performance and resilience of Bhutan grid whenever there is a system outage. We should be depending totally on Indian grid, and Bhutan will be able to operate individually as a single unit. These are some of the references.